Hi student, from today onwards we will start our IT lectures. So in this video we will take overview about HTML. So basic tags which are required for 12th and some examples programs which are required for 12th that we will continue in this lecture and video. As you know that we are designing the web page by using HTML page, and for that we are using HTML5. And all the basic tags, you know that is HTML, which is opening tag. After that, we are using head. Inside the head, we are using title. We are closing the title as per given particular title. And after that, we are closing the head tag. After that, we have to open the body tag, close body tag. Inside the body, whatever content we have to represent on web page that we are displaying. And for that, we are using different types of tags. So as we are using basic tags like bold tag, italic tag, p tag for paragraph, table tags to design the tables and all. So as along with that, we have to also learn so many different tags which are required for designing the form. And for that, to take form element, we have the form tags, and after the body tag we are using form tag. And we have to study, we have to revise actually these all elements of form. So what is the need of form tag? Actually, form is useful for, as you know that now everything is stopped because of COVID-19, and hence it is unable to take online admissions and all the things. So hence every institute is going to prefer the online mode, and for that they are also supporting the Google form. It's a nothing but example of form elements. Different types of form elements are available, like text, then radio buttons, text area, select, option buttons. These all things are there. We will see one by one. So to take a form element on web page, we require the form tag. And after the form tag, there is basically three tags which are supported to form. That is, first one is input tag. Input is the tag which is used to take inputs from user with different input controls. So in this, different input control consist, first one which is a default input control, that is text, and for that we are using attribute, that is type. So input tag having attributes like type, name. Some attributes are max length, then size, but type is important attribute to indicate which type of input control we have to take. So the default is text. To take the single line text box, we are using input type is equal to text. Then if you have to take, or if you have to select only one value, then we are using input type is equal to radio. This radio button is also known as toggle type button, means once you select one value, automatically the other's value will be disabled. If we have to take multiple selections like language known, like English, Hindi, Marathi, Japanese, then we are using checkbox. Input type is equal to checkbox. There is a default of selection. For default selection, we are using attribute of radio as well as checkbox, that is checked. Then input type is equal to button. When we have to provide different types of events, like on click events, on mouse over events, on mouse out event, like this. So when we have to write event driven program and we have to provide some event on that, we are using input type is equal to button. When we have to submit the form, we are using type is equal to submit. When we have to clear the form, then we are using input type is equal to reset. Sometime also we have to provide username and password for email, like email registration or any application registrations, we required username and password. So for that username, we can use input type is equal to text. And when we have to provide password for that, then we can use input type equal to password. So when we are going to fill the information in input type equal to password, it shows the dots or asterisk because the password should be hidden to user or anyone. These basic input types, values of type, attributes of input types, we have learned. Now the second element is drop down list, and to insert drop down list on web page we are using select tag. So select tag consists of option tag. So we can say that select tag is a container tag, because after the select tag we must have to take the option tag. It's not mandatory to close the option tag. In option tag we are filling the items or list which we have to display as a drop down list. For example, countries. So we can write countries. After that we can take the select tag. After that we can open the option tag. Inside the first option we can write India, second option we can write America, we can write anything. So list of that we can write inside the option tag, and after the option tag or list of tags, whatever list we have to upload into that is uploaded, we can close the select tag. And the most important and last input element is, or we can say that form element is text area, which is also called as multi-line text box. When we have to fill information like address or comments, because we have to give the multiple statements, we have to write store information, more information into that, because address is also not sufficient to write in single line. So also we require the multi-line, and so for that multi-line text box we required, and multi-line text box is nothing but text area. So for that we are using text area tag. So text area tags having majorly two attributes, that is rows and columns. So whereas rows indicates that how many rows we want, and column indicates that width of the text area, how much width we require. So such dimensions we can apply for the text area, and also we can store information into that. So these basic elements, or we can say that form elements, are useful for storing the information, storing the form, different types of form, or collect the information from the users. We are using these basic tags. Things I remember that before some days I have given the homework to collect different tags and its attribute. I think many of the students had submitted and sent me the homework. I also given the remark to them, but some of the students still remain to submit it. To all students I request to all to complete the homeworks as early as possible, because that is helpful for us. Today I will also give some programs as an homework, so that you will also give to me, because it's unable to take lengthy lectures, or we can say that more time. It is difficult to upload on internet, YouTube. It is also taking the too much time. There is also so many problems with the network, and also restrictions also there, because due to the COVID-19, all the IT institutions, these are also on holidays. So to also support for that system, also we have to take precaution of that. So I will give the instructions along with these lectures, these short videos, and I will also provide you different types of homeworks. You have to complete within time. Send me it personally. So then I will also, if possible or if critical programs will be there, then that output or that program also I will share on the your group regularly. I also suggest you to read chapter number 3 from 11th textbook, because that chapter is very essential for our 12th, because there is a 5 marks for HTML program and also 5 marks for JavaScript program. These two programming languages we are having for 12th, as well as there is server side scripting. So once we clear about the client side scripting, that is a JavaScript, then and then only it is easy to understand server side scripting, that is a PHP. Hence complete homework regularly. Your teachers has also planned for or they have given also timetable for that. As per that, we will also take that. And if possible, then I will also try for TeamLink, taking lectures on TeamLink and other applications also. Through that, we will be the online. We all students will be online. So it is also come to know that who is listening the lectures and not. Also, I request you that after watching this video, on the comment box, give your name. So I come to know that yes, we have watched this video completely, and also will reply me with the answers of homework. I will also send some images after the video onto your group. That will be your homework. In that homework, I will give some programs. Through that, we have to design program for development of some forms, which will be the personal information form, feedback form, or any admission registration form. So that we have to complete, and after completing, immediately send it on my personal number. I will also give a remark to you, and after watching video, also give your attendance to your class teacher. She is also waiting for your response whether you have watched the lectures or not. Thank you very much.